Hi, my name is Eric Davis, and I'm the technician here at UAV Direct. We just wanted to go ahead and do a short video for you here showing you how to use your Diversity Flysight Black Pearl monitor. That's going to be the monitor with both of the dual posts here for your receiver antenna system. So when these items sometimes will come out of the box to you, they might be set to the wrong channel or an incorrect setting. This is due to depleted battery life on the actual monitor. And that means when you receive the item, even though we have calibrated it, you might need to do one or two things to bring it back to life. So to get familiar here with this monitor, there are a couple of important buttons here. There are six of them. You have a power button. This is going to power on and off the monitor as well as enter into the menu setting, which is very important. M is for mode. We can change different modes while we're in our main screen, but this also will enter into menus that will bring up via the power button. Up and down are going to let you cycle through those menu settings, and then your plus and minus button are only reserved to change the channel. So we've already got our Phantom 2 aircraft here all set up, ready to go. It is powered on. I am charging our monitor just so that we are not depleting battery. Be aware, whenever we go into some of the menu settings, the menu will disappear pretty quickly if you don't activate one of the submenus or hit a button for a period of time. So familiarize yourself with the buttons. You can rewatch the So to power on the monitor, you just hold the button down. It takes a couple of seconds. The two red lights, one of the red lights is just indicating that I'm charging right now. And you'll see the blue lights flicker back and forth for a second, indicating it is in diversity mode. Now, what we're seeing right here is a problem that can be indicative of something. But we'll go ahead and check this out first. So if we hit our plus button cycling up through the channels, we see that we lost the channel that we were on. But the channel that appeared to look best still was not quite there. It's actually it's a pretty bad picture. Well, there's a couple of things that tell me automatically what is going on here. We've got a rolling motion on the screen, and I see no color. It's all black and white. That means more than likely the compliance mode on here is actually set to a different standard, PAL. NTSC is the standard that we need to be in, and it's actually a really, really easy way to change this. First thing that we want to do is hit our power button twice, which is going to bring up our menu here, and we want to go ahead and cycle down into function by pressing the down button, hit M, and you'll see one of the words is highlighted there. Let's go down to the second page here, and we'll see that, yes, our video system is set to PAL. Hit M once more, hit up to changes, and then we will back out by hitting the power button once, and then now we can let the screen this go away. Now, we're not still getting the best picture in here. That might be because of interference inside the building, or we might be on the wrong channel. Yes, we were on the wrong channel. Up and down for channel. You can be close to and not directly on. That was a way to fix that just there. So now we can see that the screen is a little bit dark. What I like to do, I have a series of settings, really easy to change. Just remember the numbers 65 and 40. That's what we're going to change our brightness and contrast to, and this will dramatically increase the quality of the color and brightness on the screen. So once again, enter the menu by pressing the power button twice. Sometimes it doesn't stick. There we go. And we're already in our color menu, but you can see we have a sound, function, and RF menu as well. Just make sure you're in that top one there where it says color at the top here. Hit M, and you should be in user. If you're in one of the others, go ahead and just change it to user mode, and then we can scroll down, and let's go ahead and change our brightness by hitting M again. We've highlighted there. Hit the up button, and then we're going to go to 65. It's going to be a really good level of brightness there, and we'll back out by pressing the power button once. Scroll down to contrast, press M, and let's go ahead and lower that to 45. Press the power button again. We've backed out. Back out. Now we can wait for the menu to disappear. Takes a second sometimes, I guess. Usually it takes a little bit less time than that. But, okay. So, that's a pretty quick instructional on how to set up this monitor to a series of good settings. You can play around with them, increase the brightness, lower the contrast, do anything you might like.
Hey, Eric, before we close the video, how do you adjust the band mode in the channels?
Ah, gotcha. Okay, so if we want to adjust our band or our channels, say we're trying to change channels or bands on the aircraft, one of the things that we can do is we can look at our aircraft, we can see where we're at. All transmitters are going to be slightly different, but we do have an indicator here on our transmitter saying what channel we're on. And by pressing and holding our selector button there, we can actually change bands. So if we wanted to move away from E band, which is set by default to something like A, D, or B, what we can do here is within our menu again, by pressing twice on here, we have our menu set. Press M, scroll down. Okay, we're in color, excuse me, do not press M. Let's go back here. Let's go ahead and scroll down to our RF menu. And by entering here, we can actually, by cycling into these menus, we can change our bands between A, F, E, and B. So we have several selections there. And you can actually change those for both the diversity band, which means it's going to pull between both antennas for the stronger signal, or we can individually change them right there. And then channel selection is going to be the same as it were. I might need to edit this part out. Put this back. Channel selection is going to be done just by hitting the plus or minus button. And you'll see there are 8 channels, and eventually we come back to the one we should be on.
We're not going to edit that out, Eric.
Okay.
This is raw, straightforward. Get her done. Well, get the done. Information out there.
It's done.
All right. So what if folks have any questions, Eric?
You can either call us, our number here is 855-778-6363, or you can email us, and that is at ops@uavdirect.com.
All right, thanks, Eric.
Thank you.